basically we can count the number of symbols that we are going to use in a particular number system, and that would be the base of that type of the number system. Like if we talk about the binary number system, so in binary number system we use only two numbers, 0 and 1. So 0 and 1 will be there, so total it is two numbers. So any number, any binary number will have base 2. Like we have number 1001 and it has base 2, because only two types of symbols will be used in it. Similarly, in decimal numbers, we will use the 10 digits from 0 to 9. We will use 10 digits. So that is why the base of any decimal number is, like 29 is the number, it is a decimal number, and its base is 10 only, because we are using up to 10 symbols in this particular number system. Clear? So now let's move on to the next number system. It is the octal numbers. In short, it is also called as oct. Called as oct for short. And its base is 8 numbers and uses the digits 0 to 7. So like in this, we will use 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So total they are 8 digits. So that is why the base of this octal number is 8. Clear? And octal numbers can be made from the binary numerals by grouping the consecutive binary digits into groups. So like 143. So 143 will be considered as 3 into 8 raised to power 0 plus 4 into 8 raised to power 1 plus 1 into 8 raised to power 2. So this is how we will represent the octal numbers. And radix means its base is 8. Or you can say that the total number of symbols that we will use in octal number is 8. Clear? Let's move on to the next slide. So the applications of the octal number systems are, it is used when the number of the octal number is used when the number of bits in one word is a multiple of 3. So like we have 1 0 0 1 1 1 and 1. So total they are 6 digits and it is a multiple of 3. So we can also represent this binary number into the octal form, which is easy to remember. So like for 100 we have 8 is 4, yeah, it is 4, and 111 it is 7. So instead of using these numbers 100 111, it is difficult to remember, but we can remember this 47, which is the octal form of this number. And similarly, while at the receiver end, we will separate convert it into the binary form, and it is again converted to 100 111 and 1. So this is how the octal number will be used when the number or the word is having multiple of bits, having multiple of 3. So again, let's take the another example. Now suppose if we have 1 0 0 1 0, so it is 5, and we can simply add 1 0 over it and convert it into the true form. So it will become the 2 and 2 instead of cram these numbers, we will simply put up 22. So it is also used as shorthand for representing the file permissions on Unix systems and representation of the UTF-8 numbers. Clear? Yes. Are you people clear with this octal number system? Just write down in the chat box. Okay, so next number is the hexadecimal numbers. The hexadecimal number is a number system which is called as hex for short, and it is a number system or numeral system made of 16 symbols. So that is why its base is 16, or we can also say that its radix is 16, means the 16 symbols we will use in this number system. So the standard numeral system is called the decimal base 10 and uses 10 symbols 0 to 9. So 10 symbols will use, and for the remaining 6 symbols we will use A, B, C, D, E and F. So like 0 will be represented as 0 up to 9. It is represented as 9, but when we move from 10 to 15, so 10 will be represented by A, 11 with 15, 12 with C, 13 D, 14 E and 15 F. And to represent any number in hexadecimal form, how it will be implemented? So 3 in octal number, we have implemented 3 into 8 raised to the power 0. So here base is 16. So we will write down 3 into 16 raised to the power 0, then 4 into 16 raised to the power 1, and then 1 into 16 raised to the power 2. So that number will be in the hexadecimal form and its base is 16. Clear? Yes, everyone. Okay, so hexadecimal number can be used to write the large binary numbers in just a few digits. So like if we have a number like 1 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 0, so it has 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 1 and 1. So to represent this binary number, if we divide it into octal number system, we have to generate the four symbols. But when we use the hexadecimal number system, we will use only 3 digits, like 1 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 and 0 1 1 1. So basically that number will be 1 0 0 1 is 9, then 0 1 0 1 is 6, and then 0 1 1 1 is 7. So instead of remembering these high digit number, we will simply convert it into hexadecimal, and its conversion is 9 6 and 7. So it makes life easier, that it allows grouping of binary numbers that will be easier to read, write and understand. So this hexadecimal number is human friendly. So we can also use grouping together numbers, and that is why the things will be easier to understand. Clear? Yes, everyone. So then is a number based conversion. So there are many methods or techniques that will be used to convert the binary number system from one base to another base. So basically we have four number systems and we can convert any number system to the another number system, its values and its symbols. So we have decimal to other base system to decimal, binary to octal, octal to binary, binary to hexadecimal and the vice versa. So decimal to other base system is, first of all, divide the decimal number to be converted by the value of the new base. So whatever the new number system in which we will convert the decimal numbers, we have to divide it with its base. And one step to remember that we do not divide it into the decimal numbers, like in the floating point numbers. So we will then get the remainder from step one and put it at the rightmost digits of the new base number. So if the value is again greater than base, divide the quotient of previous with the new base and again record the remainder, and we have to repeat the steps until and unless the number for the remainder will be less than the new base. So this is the example of decimal to binary conversion. So the step one is we have decimal number 13 and we have to convert it into the binary number. So base of binary number is 2. So how it will happen? So 13 will be divided by 6 and remainder will be 1. Then 2, 6 will be divided by 2, we have a remainder 0, then 1, and then 1. So now here, see, the remainder is less than 2. So you can also leave the steps over here. You need not to multiply it with the 0. So then you have to write down from bottom to the top, and that will be your binary number. Do not write from top to bottom. That will, your answer will be wrong in that case. Okay. So the number, the 13 decimal number base 10 will be converted to binary number with values 1, 1, 0, and 1. Clear? So then to convert the number to octal numbers instead of 2, now we have the number the new number will be octal. So we will divide it with 8. So 95 is there. So 8, 11, 88 and 7, 95, so 7, 3, 1 and 0. So 137 will be the conversion of this 95 into octal number system. And similarly, we have one more example. 214 will be converted to And again, the decimal to hexadecimal number system or conversion. So 2545 will be converted like this. So its values are 1, 15, 15 will be converted to F because it is greater than 9. So that is why it will be greater than F. And then we have 9. So its conversion is 9F1. 2989. When we convert it into the hexadecimal, we have values remainders 13, 10, and 11. So for that, we have 2989 will be converted to decimal number, that is BAD, bad. Clear?